Okay, so let's have the design of the tension member. Okay, so isa-isay natin, no? So we have the tension, the compression, and then the flexure. So we'll tension muna tayo. Okay, so let's have the problem. So a 12 mm by 625 mm plate of A36 steel. So kung walang binigay na FY automatic na kapag A36 normally, no? Generally, ang ginagamit natin is 248 megapascal. And then yung ultimate natin is 400 megapascal. It's used as a tension member. It is connected using 16 mm bolts. Okay? Assume that the effective net area equals to the net area AN. So what is the design strength and what is the allowable strength? Okay, so it means for the letter A, we are asked to use for the LRFD method. And then for the B, we are asked to use for the ASD method. Okay, so one thing I want to emphasize is this note that assume that the effective net area AE is equal to the AN. So medyo magkaiba sila, no? So later on, i-discuss natin. Kasi meron itong section what is tinatawag nating shear lag factor. Okay? So for now, we will have this one. Okay? So unahin muna natin for the LRFD method. Okay? So LRFD muna tayo for letter A. LRFD. Okay? So, meron tinatawag na limit states. Okay? So, yung limit states, yun yung parang, ayun tawag natin dito. Nakalimutan ko yung tawag. Yung term, in a way, that is the way kung saan masisira yung isang bagay na nakalimutan ko. Mode of failure, ayan. So, it is also called the mode of failure, no? So, dalawa. Okay? So, the first one, for the tension member, we will be having as yielding. Okay? So, dalawa yung basic na, pero parang merong masab, yung tinatawag natin block shear. Okay? So, for the meantime, we will be having separate topic on that. So, we will be having first on the yielding strength. Okay? So, yung yielding natin at saka yung rupture natin mamaya para lang yung sa deformable na P all over A. Okay? So, yung ating P sub N, okay? So, yung P sub N natin, it is just equal to Fy multiplied by the gross area AG. Okay? Wherein, this is the force over the area equals to the stress. Okay, so parang ganun lang siya. So, now, when the subscript is N, it's called the nominal. Okay, so this is called nominal. Okay. So, meron tayong Fy which is D3-248. Kunahin natin si AG. Okay? Si AG, ganito yung gagawin natin. Ano? Kukuha tayo para tayo magka-cut ng cross-section area kung saan wala ka munang tatamaang bolts. Okay? So, we will be having, let's say, we cut on this part, okay? Tapos, kunin natin yung cross-section area niya. So, that cross-section area, parang ito lang yon, okay? Yung buo. Okay? Na kung saan yung thickness niya, yung mas maliit na dimension sa plate, so that is 12 mm. Okay? Okay? And then, this distance, okay, yun yung kabilang size, which is the 625 mm. Okay? So, kunin mo lang yung cross-sectional area. So, that is the gross area, yung buo, walang halong butas. So, that's just equal to 625 multiplied it by 12. So, you will have it 625 times 12. So, you have 7,500 mm squared. Okay? So, actually, pwede na natin makuha kagad si P sub N. Oh. So, P sub N, it's just equal to Fy, which is equal to 248, multiplied by the gross area, 7,500 mm squared. Okay, kaya lang yung resulting nito is in Newton. Okay, so para maging kilo Newton, we divide it already by 1,000. So, the resulting is 248 times 7,500 divided by 1,000. So, you can have it 1,860 kilo Newton. Okay, ito yung actual na lakas niya, no? Yun yung capacity based on the gross area. Kaya lang, hindi iyan yung gagamitin kagad natin. Okay? So, we will be have it as ultimate. So, yung PU natin, for the yielding, we will be having as phi multiplied by P sub N. Okay? Wherein, for phi for the tension, okay, under yielding, so you will have it 0.9. So, we will be having as PU equals to 0.9 multiplied by 1,860. So, that's equal to 1,674 kilonewton. So, you have the first answer. Kaya lang, hindi pa yun yung design strength, ano? Because this is just under the yielding. Okay, so pupunta tayo sa tinatawag nating rupture. Okay? So, rupture, ganun pa rin. So, we will be having as P sub N. Kaya lang, instead na yielding yung gagamitin natin, ang gagamitin natin is yung FU. So, we will be having the formula FU multiplied by the effective net area. Okay? So, ito yung sinasabi ko kanina. Kaya lang, para makuha si effective net area, okay? So, we will be multiplying what we call the shear lag factor and the A sub N. So, this is called the net area. Okay, and this one is called shear lag factor. Okay, however, okay, for a certain plate, okay, so for connection plate, okay, so we will be having U, pag isa lang yung connected member, automatic, your U would become equal to 1.0. Okay, so anyway, we will discuss that further, yung shear lag factor, okay, sa mga susunod na topics. Okay? So, for the meantime, we will take for the nominal. Net area. Okay? So, for the net area, kukunin naman natin dito, okay? Na kung saan, okay? Kunin natin yung part na kung saan merong bolt. Okay? So, sa problem natin, tig-2 lang, no? Okay? So, pwedeng tama siya. Pero later on, pag meron na tayong tinatawag na staggered, meron ding effect yung staggered connection. No? So, for the meantime, kunin natin to. Okay? So, yung section na yun. Tapos, meron kang dalawang bolts na tinamaan. Okay? Ito yung isa. Ito yung dalawa. No? So, pag kinat ko dun. Ito lang yung net area. Okay? Ayan lang yung net area. Okay? So, in short, para siyang gross area, kaya lang ibabawas natin yung area ng hole. Okay? So now, how to solve for the area of hole? So area ng hole, okay? So kukunin natin itong part ng thickness natin, which is the 12 mm. Okay? Parang iyan lang yung rectangle, ano? Dalawang bolts, okay, 2 bolts. Okay, multiplied natin by, okay, 12 mm as the thickness, and then multiply natin by the diameter. Ito diameter to eh. Okay, so that is 16. Kaya lang, hindi lang 16. Okay, so 16. Okay, so may part dyan, sinasabi na you should add 1 over 16. Based on the AISC, it's 1 over 16 inch or 2 mm. Sa NSCP 2015, nakalagay is 2 mm. Okay, for standard hole. Kaya lang, okay, ipopost ko, no? So, yung pinaka-provision. Kaya lang, yung 1 over 16 na yon, okay, hindi sapat yan, ano? So, there's a commentary on the AASC na sinasabi na there should be 1 over 16 para dun sa pinaka-hole. Okay, kasi pag pinunch mo yung hole, hindi naman saktong-saktong 16 mm yan, ano? Okay, pag pinunch mo yung hole, meron tayong tolerance. And that is the 1 over 16 inch. Okay, sa AISC, that is 1 over 16 inch. Okay, or that's about 1.6 mm. Okay, kaya na-round up ng 2. Kaya lang, aside from that, meron pang tolerances for the construction. So, you should add another 1 over 16. Kaya ang nagiging ina-add talaga sa area ng hole actually is 1 over 8 inch. Okay? So, kapag nilagay natin in millimeter, that is around 3.2 mm. And actually, ito yung gamit ni Salmon, C.G. Salmon. So, I will post the excerpt from his book. Okay? So, 3.2 mm. So, we will be using this one. Iyon yung medyo mahirap sa atin. Okay? Kasi yung NSCP 2015 is wala naman siyang commentary. So, we do not know ano yung gagamitin ni examiner na addition para dun sa bolt hole natin, no? Pero based on the international books, we could use the 3.2 mm. So we will follow this one. Okay, so plus 3.2 millimeter. Okay? So yung ibang ginagamit is 3 mm. So yung iba ginagamit is just 2 mm. Okay? Or if you will follow the NSCP, which is yung conversion niya ng 1 over 16 inch is 2 mm, another 2 mm, you can use the 4 mm. Okay? So, we do not know ano yung gagamitin kasi wala naman tayong direct conversion. Okay? So, for now, we will follow the excerpt sa book ni C.G. Salmon. Okay? So, we will be having this one, 2, multiplied it by 12, multiplied it by 16 plus 3.2. So, we will be having as 460.8 mm squared. Alright? So, now, we will be having the area of hole. Dito ko na ilagay. So, area of hole. So, that's equal to area ng gross, area net. Sorry, I'm speaking of area net. Area is 7,500. Ima-minus natin yung 460.8. So you will be having as 7,500 minus 460.8. Okay, or that's equal to 7,039.2. Okay, so now for this one, so meron na tayo, kukunin na natin ngayon si A sub E. But A sub E is equals to UAN. But yung U natin will be taken as 1.0, so we can have it as 7,039.2 mm squared. Okay? And then with that, pwede na akong kumuha ng nominal for the rupture. So that's equal to Fu, which is 400 megapascal, multiplied it by the AE, 7,039.2. Okay? I-divide ko na by 1,000 para maging kilo Newton. So we will be having as 400 times 7039.2 over 1,000. So we will have it as 2,815.68. Okay? Kaya lang, nominal lang yan. So for the PU, okay? Okay? So PU, again, that would become phi PN. Okay? Kaya lang, for the rupture, ang gagamitin na nating phi is 0.75. Okay? So again, 0.75 for the rupture, we will be using 0.9 for the yielding. Okay? So, rupture is based on the net area while yielding is based on the gross area. So, we will be having the PU equals to 0.75 multiplied it by 2815.68. Okay? So, we will be having as 0.75 times 2815.68. So, 2,111.76 kilonewton. Okay? Ngayon, dalawa yung nakuha natin. Isang 1,674 at isang 211.76. Okay? Parang ganito, no? Yung muscle mo, parang sa iba't ibang pagbubuhat, dalawa yung kaya niyang buhatin. Okay? Minsan, kaya niyang buhatin 1,674. Minsan, kaya niyang buhatin 211. So, para ma-safe ka, pipiliin mo yung pinakamababa mong capacity. Okay? So, to do this, the lower capacity between the two is the 1,674. So, your ultimate or your design strength is 1,674 kilo Newton. Okay, so this is now your answer. Okay, so now for the ASD, palitan lang natin to. So we will be having almost the same lang yan. So we will have it as ASD. Okay. Ganun pa rin yung nominal mo. Okay, ang mababago lang dito for the ASD, instead na VPN, okay, ito, mapapalitan natin to, ano? Okay. So, instead na PU, gagawin ko naman siyang A. So, that's, it means it is allowable. So, ang sa kanya naman is PN divided by the omega. Okay? So, yung omega na yan, para kay ASD, it's 1.67 para kay yielding. So, in 2001 NSCP, that is 0.6 FYAG, no? Yung PA natin, 0.6 FYAG. Same lang yon. Kasi kapag dinivide mo yung 1 over 1.67, 1 divided by 1.67, it is around 0.5988 or is exactly 0.6. Okay? So, for this one, yung PA natin, i-divide ko lang siya ng 1860. I-divide ko siya ng 1.67. So, you will be have it as 1113.77 kilonewton. Okay? So, 1. So, ito ganun din pag nakuha natin yung PN hanggang dito. Okay na yan. So, dito na lang tayo magbabago. Okay? So, instead na PU, magiging PA siya. Okay? So, we will be having as PA this time. So, that is equals to PN divided by the omega. Yung omega natin or yung factor of safety natin para kay rupture. Okay? And that's equal to 2. Okay? So, same lang yun sa ASD natin noong 2001, which is 1 over 2, 1 half, that is 0.5. Okay? Kaya naging, ano to eh, 0.5 FUAE. Okay? So, we will be having PA equals to, PN is 2815.68 divided by 2. So, you will be having PA 2815.68 divided by 2. So, we can have it as 1407.84 kilonewton. So, pipili tayo ng mas mababa sa dalawa. So, it's either this on the yielding or on the rupture, pero mas mababa si yielding. So, yielding governs 113.77 kilonewton. Hence, this is your answer. That's it. So, next time, we'll be having the staggered connections, the block shear, and then the shear lag factor.